never like to see a player go down like that, but...
Definitely not. She's still in her bag.
They're just giving her a second, I guess, to breathe it out, and they're going to help her up, but...
You got to commend any player who's willing to get their body in the way like that to take a charge. It's one of the hardest skills to teach, and it's something that comes naturally to very few. Looks a little shaken, but all around okay.
Joins the huddle. I think she might have wanted to stay in there for a second and wasn't sure who it was beside her there. Just telling her to take a little bit of a breather.
Maybe she's staying a star still. But she wants to be in there with only 3 minutes and 30 seconds left. UPI is trailing by 3 points.
Definitely been nice competitive game here between UPEI and Queens.
Giving the crowd something to cheer for, getting them on the edge of their seat.
And
a great defensive effort there by Liz Ball. Getting up in her body, making her uncomfortable, and then planning just in time for her to take that charge.
Draws the charge to the hatcher, so Queens will get the ball back deep in UPEI territory.
Her second team third.
Inbound to Bramble. Over to Bo. Bo working on Donahoe. Out wide to Dixon. Dixon now into the paint. Goes to Pearson.
Beautiful. Abby Dixon dropping a dime for Pearson there. Convert for another 2 points.
Gaels have a 5-point lead. Now it's going to be Jones driving the lane. Going to kick it out. Sends it around. Rigby now with it. Ball does not fall into the basket, so it's going to be the Gaels with it. Jenny Wright moving up the court. Bogue now with it. Wright
Primo
finds a little bit of space, floats it. No good, though.
Primo with great defensive position, grabbing that board, giving them time to bring up the ball.
Baseline possession, Panthers.
Robin Pearson is leading the Gaels with 14 points on the night.
Rigby's going to inbound. Goes to Hatcher. Bogue on Hatcher, and Bogue steals it.
She is not letting up that pressure. She wants her team to keep this momentum.
A little bit of a mismatch there with Bogue covering Hatcher. And it's going to go inside to Pearson. She can't get it to fall. And the ball is going to go out of bounds, and UPI is going to get it. Pearson tried to draw the foul there.
Pearson seems to just be in the right place at the right time these past few possessions. Couldn't convert on that last one.
And UPEI smartly doesn't challenge Bogue, as she's been unstoppable on defense there for a little bit.
As you can see, as they went to a different player to bring up the ball there. Ooh, tried to attack into a set of trees. Arms high, got that ball cleanly.
Yeah, Donahoe just kind of worked herself into a sandwich of Gaels players, couldn't do anything with it. Priamo now with it. Sends it back out to Bogue. It's good. Only worth 2 points, so as toes on the line.
As we said before, because of the new three-point line, only 2 points, but beautiful nonetheless. Nice shot for Bogue. Not giving her any breathing room.
Bogue on defense on Hatcher on the far side there, but it's going to be kicked out to Jones. Just by tossing the ball up as if she might do a three-pointer, is it able to make enough space for
Julie Hatcher for three.
And Hatcher makes the basket for three.
It is a 4-point game now. Good aggression there by Abby Dixon.
Number 13, Kira Rigby.
Sensed a little bit of space. And it was Rigby that took the foul. So
her fourth, team score.
Dixon on the line.
Dixon doing it too.
At four fouls, but only a minute and a half left, so she'll stay in the game.
And she'll make the first. This is great. Fourth quarter free throw shooting is very on point for Queens. It's something that they definitely needed.
Robin, still a little bit of problems with that free throw shooting.
Robin Pearson's there.
And they're going to kick it out wide to Bogue. Bogue's going to put it up. No good. Pearson almost gets it, but now it's going to go it off Pearson.
Good effort there by Robin Pearson and Jenny Wright.
So it'll be Rigby to inbound. Queens 54, UPEI 49. minute 18 left to play, and we're going to get a timeout here.
Coming down to crunch time. And this is what the crowd really is here for. They're making it a game.
If you were UPEI coach Greg Gould, would you just be telling UPEI to foul as much as you can? Get Queens to the line. Normally I would say 5-point game, maybe not the best strategy, but with Queens free throw shooting today.
You would think so, but I honestly think that they're just going to keep the pressure up until they run down the clock a little bit more and just convert on the offensive end. UPEI just hasn't really been sinking the past few shots other than the three-pointer that was just recently made.
Very true, but I don't know. It's just a minute 18 left. UPEI, they haven't exactly screamed fast-paced offense to me today. Just kind of taking their time setting up.
That's true. Making the baskets
count, so it'll be interesting to see what they choose to do.
Maybe they'll try to get into their three-point shooter's hands or even over to Candace Smith, who's been playing very well for UPEI today. What they're going to want to do is whoever's hands they put it into, they don't want Bogues regarding her because she has changed this game with her full court pressure.
Yeah, Bogues has very quick feet, always bouncing around, trying to make something happen.
She's one of those aggressive, active players all the time on the court. Yeah. She's giving everything for her team, and you can tell that is why she is the team captain and has been a starting point guard for 4 years.
Yeah, came in and started right away for the Gaels. And she's guarding Donna. Oh, no, that has it. And that's going to be sent out to Hatcher. Oh, isn't actually guarding anyone now in her zone defense right now. Although she takes out Jones when it would come out there, but it's going to be Donahoe from the corner.
That is a shot they want. They just couldn't convert on that one.
Yeah, the three-point arc doesn't quite extend out all that way. There's a little bit of a flattening off, so you can get a little bit closer to the basket. But
Gaels looking to run some clock here, waiting for the best shot opportunity.
Looks like Dixon was thinking about taking it, but wisely chose to pass it out to Wright, and it's going to be Wright drawing the foul.
That is four team fouls for UPEI. Actually, that is five, so she is at the line.
Her third, Team Smith. Jenny Wright to the line for two.
Yeah, one of the Gaels assistant coaches wondering why it was a shooting foul originally, I think, because he just wanted them to maintain possession.
Jenny Wright couldn't make that first one.
Yeah, see, this is the thing. If you're fouling Queens, especially someone like Jenny Wright, who has not been having success tonight at the free throw line,
that would be a good game plan.
Although, UPEI is down by six.
Gaels are relentless right now with their pressure.
Guarding Hatcher. I don't know, if I'm the Gaels, you don't want to foul them just because you want to take some time off the clock, but as soon as
spoke
I said that.
Spoke too soon. Robin Pearson, is that her fifth foul?
Yes. She's going to foul out of the game. Looks like it's going to be Haslett possibly coming on for it.
But Pearson did have a great showing today.
It's actually going to be Bullard, so
they need some physical presence down low. Bullard's one of those players who can not only shoot and has great range, but she's also a physical defender.
Definitely makes a little bit more sense than Haslett, but Haslett was the first to jump off the bench, so
put me in, coach, put me in.
Second shot.
Taylor Herrick makes the first free throw, trying to make a four-point game, and no good, and it's rebounded by Queens. They're going to give the ball to Bogue. A little spin around.
Fouling right away there.
Number 12, Julie Hatcher.
That'll be Hatcher's third foul of the game.
Liz Bogue heading to the line.
Gaels in the bonus. Liz Bogue shooting two.
Looking to make this a 7-point lead. Liz Bogue makes the first.
That'll be her 10th point of the game, so she's going to get into double digits in points. A little bit of a low total in some ways for her.
Yeah, but she's a very consistent scorer.
The basket doesn't fall, the Queen is going to get it. Now Bogue's just going to run around.
The thing that has been saving the Gaels today is their offensive rebounding.
They've been coming down with, definitely their fair share.
Panthers foul on number 12, Julie Hatcher.
That is something I remember that in the end of the last season, they really wanted to address the boards, and it seems like they're getting that done right now, and it's helping them maintain the lead in this game.
So Hatcher took another foul there, so she's going to be at four, and she'll be taken off, although I don't think it really matters.
Folks thinks that first one and one more. 57-50 for the Gaels.
Yeah, Bogue kind of took advantage of Hatcher there late.
She just wanted a few more free throws, a couple more chances.
So, it's going to be Smith now taking the ball up for UPEI. Not the best shot. UPEI's got to do something quickly here. Rigby with it now. Launches it up. Not the greatest attempt, and
a clever little tip by Gemma Bullard there. Making sure that she didn't get that second attempt at the net.
Only 5.7 seconds left on the clock, so I think it's going to be too late for UPEI. It looks like Queens is going to win their opener of the Tyndall Invitational. The final score might be a little bit different, but Rigby can't take that, so that's going to end it. The UPEI falls to the Gaels. 58-50.
Gives the home crowd something to cheer about on the first night of their tournament.
Definitely a good way to start off the tournament. Well, there were definitely some positives to be taken from, but I don't know that I'd call it a great game by the Gaels. Shooting percentage was pretty low, but
they went up and down, but you know what? They grinded it out, and they'll just be back for tomorrow, ready to take on their next opponent.
So we encourage you guys to switch over. We're going to do the next game between Manitoba Bisons and the Queens Gaels men's team. That's it for us for now. Thank you for tuning in to this broadcast of Queens Gaels Athletics here on Queens TV.